Would you like to easily navigate through your QuickBooks Online account and be able to find anything easily in your QuickBooks Amazon online store? Well, this video will show you how to pay general administrative expenses that have nothing to do with Amazon, but you have to pay them anyway. And as a bonus, I'm going to show you how you can find anything easily in your QuickBooks Online account. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Any company, even an Amazon online business, has to record non-Amazon general administrative expenses, just like any other company pays normal expenses. You would use the right checks window even if you pay online, or you could use the expense window because in QuickBooks Online, they're both basically the same thing. The cash in bank will decrease and the recorded expense account will increase at the moment you record a check or an expense type of transaction. Those expenses will show up at the bottom of the profit and loss report. For example, let's imagine on May 15th, we paid Con Edison for utilities $1,000 with check number 61. Cash will decrease by $1,000 and utilities expense will show up for the first time as $1,000. So if you click reports and you look at your trial balance, right now we don't have utilities expense at all, and right now cash in bank is $7,157. But after we record paying $1,000 administrative expense, cash will go down to $6,157, and utilities expense will show up for the very first time on the trial balance as $1,000. So now the date is May 15th, and it's check number 61. So what do we do? Well, in the top left, we click New, and again, if you're paying online, you would click the expense window. And you will notice, just close this, this expense window looks exactly like the check window. Instead of saying check number, it says reference number. But it has the exact same result in your trial balance and your profit and loss. So let's close it out and click New, Check. It's the same thing. And we'll put check number 61. Now, the payee is Con Edison. If Con Edison is not on the list, we click Add New, and we make sure that QuickBooks knows it's a vendor, and Con Ed is the electric company here in New York. Now, what day are we paying them? Well, we're paying them on May 15th. So, May 15th of 2019 in our little story. And the category is utilities expense, which is definitely an expense that QuickBooks Online already put on the list. Then we put in the amount we're paying and then click Save and Close. Now you can see cash in bank has decreased by $1,000 and become $6,157, and utilities expense has shown up for the first time as $1,000. And if you click reports and then click profit and loss, you can see utilities expense goes in the bottom expense section after the profit and the income right here, and it lowers your overall net income. Now, the best way to find any previous transaction that you previously entered is to double-click that number in the trial balance. For example, if we wanted to see the check we just wrote, we would click Reports, Trial Balance, and we know that that check was recorded in Cash and Chase Bank. So we can double-click the number, and then we will get a list of every number that adds up to the final number in the trial balance. So you can see this was the deposit that made an increase by the $9,657. Then these were purchases that we paid from the cash and bank account. And the last one was an administrative expense, which is a check that we paid $1,000 for. And if we actually want to see the transaction that we just recorded, we can double-click anywhere on the line, and QuickBooks Online will bring us back to that exact window that we recorded the transaction. And we can make any change that we want if we had any kind of mistake. And as soon as we save the changes, the numbers in the trial balance would fix themselves. The other recommended way that you can find anything easily is to use the QuickBooks Online Advanced Search Tool. It's right up here in the magnifying glass. You just click it and then click Advanced Search. For example, if you wanted to find all the checks that you wrote specifically to one payee, the payee being Con Edison, you would click checks for the transaction type, and you searching in checks for by payee, and the name of the payee includes Con Ed. Type that in and then click search. You would get a list of every check that you wrote just to Con Edison. What if you wanted to find the checks by amount? You would click amount and the amount that equals 1,000. And then you would click search. And of course, you only have one check that equals 1,000. But you could search for checks that are greater than a specific amount or less than a specific amount. What if you wanted to find all of the deposits before a specific date? So last modified date, how about before what date? Before today's date. Click search, and we only have one, but you would get a list of every deposit before the date that you put. So again, to open it up, you click the magnifying glass and click advanced. And I invite you to explore and experiment with choosing first the transaction type, then what criteria you want to find the transaction type on, type in the specifics, and then click search, and you will be able to find anything you're looking for in this QuickBooks Online account. Once it comes up in the search result, you can double-click and go right back to the window that you originally recorded it in and make any change you need, and the numbers will change accordingly. I also suggest for people who want to prove that their QuickBooks Online records are correct that you take the course Bank Reconciliation and Proving Correctness, and it's available right here on this website. The Bank Feeds course is also available, but you have to be careful if you are recording deposits in the way that we need to while downloading your expenses and payments from the bank. Anything else that you might need in QuickBooks Online, I have available videos for right here on this website. So if there's something else you feel you need, you should contact me immediately. I thank all Amazon workers for helping us during this very difficult time, and I look forward to hearing from you.